there are clinically important outcome differences between neostigmine versus Sugammadex. Brandon Togioka, some months ago, published a nice overview of how to optimize reversal of neuromuscular block by choosing between Sugammadex and or neostigmine. Now, the results were fairly consistent across upper part observational studies, lower part randomized control trials. Sugammadex provided a protective effect, but the majority of studies, look at the most right side of the slide in red, showing a 20 to 30% lower relative odds of post-operative pulmonary complications for patients that received Sugammadex. The stronger study, data from a general population, all outcomes in favor of Sugammadex, pulmonary complications, risk of pneumonia, risk of respiratory failure, meaning reintubation in the post-anesthesia care unit, were all in favor of Sugammadex. And after the stronger study came the still stronger study. The still stronger study, a study with the same population as the stronger study, but only looking at the patients at risk, being those ones with ASA physical status 3 or 4, undergoing intrathoracic or intra-abdominal surgery. Quite logical, those surgeries with the highest incidence and the highest risk of POPCs. Patients with an age of 80 years or older, or undergoing surgery lasting longer than 2 hours. And all these data, all these odds ratios were again in favor of Sugammadex. They were independently associated with reduced odds of development of a composite of major post-operative pulmonary complications in favor of Sugammadex compared with those patients who receive neostigmine.